Alright, last time I was out here with the cub, we suffered a catastrophic failure with the buddy box. And she ate the dirt and the wing got destroyed. And I was going to buy a new one, but that was like $30. So I made a new Dollar Tree wing. And this will be the maiden carbon cub with the Dollar Tree wing. I left the struts off, and it weighs about the same. So this is a 300 milliamp 2-cell. We're gonna try it on. And got a little bit of wind.
Perfect. Landed it perfectly. I need to move the CG like a mile forward. Should I do it with lead or what? What do you think?
I don't know. There's all kinds of wind. There's a car coming.
Hold on. Give me just a second. Disconnect this thing so I don't. Yeah. Shit, yeah, dude. Fast. Is that intended?
Nope. That's mega roll now.
Damn. What?
Well, I made the ailerons across the span, so.
You need any adjustments made?
No, it's flying great.
It's quick.
Well, a little down over there. That's awesome.
That is sweet, dude.
It's way faster.
Yeah, it is.
It doesn't have the same float like it used to.
The same float?
Oh, maybe it does. The other one had a real nice camber on the wing there. This is pretty flat.
You got great performance right
now. I know, it's crazy. Okay, here we are. I took the cub wing and I just traced it out on Dollar Tree form board or ready board and added it to the cub, and it flew great. You can see that it's identical. It's considerably stiffer than this, and you can see I was. My brother's a kid and whatnot, had the buddy box going on, and it was just unrecoverable, so the wing got pretty messed up, and I taped it back, and it worked fine for a while, but I just decided to see if we could find a better solution here. So, here it is installed. I just trimmed down a little bit of a leading edge there, and scored it, pulled it back and cut a 45, and then added some hinge tape, and then I just reattached the servos with some double-sided tape, and then cut a notch and buried the servo leads in there, and it worked really good. What is interesting is I went ahead and dug out some old Guillow cup lines from the garage here. This is the Kit 303 Piper Super Cub 95. And just some similarities, which are quite a few. Here's the struts, which I did not add back. That fits right on there. Here's the wing. You can see that it's identical there. The dimensions are identical as well. Span 24. There's the back. You get the horizontal stabilizer. There's the rudder. Hopefully the perspective lines up. Let's see here. Anyway, you could take these plans and if you had a desire to remanufacture stuff. I know they sell them online for, I think, $3 or $4. You can even get the plastic molded parts, a whole set of them, really cheap as well. I think $2 or $3. And you can see that the dimensions really do line up very well, so it'd be good, something to consider. Anyway, this wing flew great, as you see from the video. I think I just will come up with a little bit of weight savings. I didn't measure it, but I dropped the fifth servo for the flaps. Didn't think it needed them in the first place. Something fun, though. And it flies great. I still fly it, and it's one of my favorite planes ever. Thanks.